People say when you're pregnant, you're eating for two, but according to the math, you're really only eating for 1.15. Hey there, kids. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for tuning in. Half of Earth's population takes nutrients from food and use them to build a human inside of their body. But what's the construction cost on that? How many calories does it cost to make a little bundle of joy? How many calories it takes for a pregnant woman to healthily make a baby, day to day, is a little nebulous. It's not just food intake, because existing muscle, bone, and fat tissues are broken down for fetal needs too. But according to the Journal of Tropical Pediatrics and the American Pregnancy Association, the average cost of the entire pregnancy seems to be about 300 extra kilocalories a day, or about 3 tablespoons of peanut butter or a couple of hamburger buns. If you multiply that out, human gestation averaging 280 days, 40 weeks, or close to 10 months at 300 calories a day, that means a pregnant woman will need 75,000 calories to create a human. But to put 75,000 calories in perspective, it's only a snack or two per day. It's not that much. UK dietitian Sasha Watkins describes 200 calories as a small toasted pita filled with a tablespoon of reduced fat hummus and grated carrot, followed by 3 apricots. Or a low-fat yogurt with 6 almonds. So overall, eating for two, while technically accurate, doesn't mean doubling food intake, and instead could mean eating as little as 2 slices of whole grain bread with a tablespoon of cottage cheese. Brits are weird. What the body does with those calories is even more weird, though. Caloric increases aren't spread evenly across the whole pregnancy and do not directly correlate with actual fetal growth. They could be used for anything. Pregnant women will, for example, grow 50% more blood throughout the pregnancy. Also, the 75,000 is the total. It's not 300 calories from day 1 to day 280, it ramps up. At the end of the first trimester, the fetus is only 28 grams and doesn't require additional nutrition. But let's run the numbers. The Journal of Tropical Pediatrics reports the mean increases for the women that they studied were 9 calories per day for the first trimester, 8 for the second trimester, and a sharp increase to 216 for the third. While the American Pregnancy Association says women should eat normally in the first trimester, increase by 340 calories in the second and 450 in the third. Then researchers in the UK say eat normal for the first trimester, increase by 200 in the second and 300 in the third. But these numbers will change based on BMI, activity level, metabolism, and height. But honestly, all this variation shows that we still have a lot to learn about pregnancy. It's not like we can slap a meter on a fetus and see what they need. Scientists aren't entirely sure how the body decides which nutrients go to the fetus and which go to the mother, but one thing was clear across all the research I found. Since growing tissues takes food energy, and we are what we eat, it was heavily emphasized that the diet of a pregnant woman should be a healthy one. Craving fatty or unhealthy foods is normal and shouldn't be ignored or derided, but we could all use a reminder to eat healthily. So when you're hungry, eat those extra 75,000 calories, lady friends, and enjoy building your own little human. Half of these baby humans will eventually grow up and need to shave one of these lovely beards. So we'd like to thank Harry's for sponsoring this episode. I use Harry's twice a week to shave my neck, and the blades are super sharp, and the aftershave smells great. A starter kit includes 3 razors, a handle, and your choice of shave cream or foaming shave gel. I go for the gel. Go to harrys.com now and get your starter kit for only 15 bucks. And with our code DNews, you get 5 bucks off. Backing up a bit though, pregnancy isn't even the easiest thing in the world to pull off. Both men and women have a ton of considerations and things have to go just right. So how hard is it for people to get pregnant? We looked at it right here.
Besides age, the weirdest things can affect your fertility. Like research from the Norwegian University of Science and Technology found that women who work out too much can have reduced fertility.
Do y'all have any pregnancy tips for your friends or maybe things that people can do to help you guys stick to a healthy diet? Let us know down in the comments. Thanks for coming to DNews and we'll see you next time.